Hello students, welcome to another video from Shomu's Biology. And this video is intended for the primary and high school students to talk about a very interesting subject, and that is heredity, which is a part of genetics. So we'll talk about what is heredity and how heredity actually works. Have you ever imagined that many people tell you that you are looking more like your father or you're looking more like your mother? What is the reason behind it? Why we think that people look like their parents? There is some relation between them, right? And we call this as a heredity, the inheritance pattern. That means there are something that is transferred from our parents into us, which helps us to have all the features, kind of mixed and match features from both of our parents, our father and mother. So let's talk about the heredity in details. So I'm going to use my ViewBoard application in myviewboard.com, and here with the help of the whiteboard also I'll be showing you a document where I discuss about all this in details, okay, and also tell you how exactly heredity works. Okay, so let me first import one of my document, that is genetics, the DNA as well as the heredity, the concept of heredity here. Okay, so first I'll talk about the broad concept of heredity, then I'll be talking about the details of it, okay, and the genetics behind the idea of heredity. So the very first things first here is that I'm going to show you the PowerPoint mode here, and I can clearly see the PowerPoint mode, the number of slides, 6 slides are there. So let's start with the idea of heredity. And what we know here is that heredity is passing of traits from parents to the offsprings, okay? And I can take this to highlight any important information I want with this green highlight. While in genetics, it's a study of how traits are passed from parent to the offspring. For example, this is a funny picture when one person is saying, why you have a long face? And the other one replying, heredity. Yes, it is a kind of a thing, you know, there are heredity everywhere. If you look at your parents and you, you'll find some similarity. If you see your friends and their parents, you'll find some similarity. So the similarities are everywhere regarding the heredity, regarding this idea. Okay, so let's see why and how this heredity is present, and what is heredity in details. The thing is, you know, when I say heredity, it is a process of passing of traits and characteristics. Remember, again, let me take the highlighter. Process of passing the traits and characteristics from parents to the offspring. Okay, the offspring cells get their features and characteristics, and it also get this genetic information from their mother as well as their father. I take this picture, and you can clearly see in this picture that the son receives some property from the father, some property from the mother. See here, the father has a black colored hair, the mother has a blonde hair. But what this son is getting, son got the hair color from the mother. So son has a blonde hair color, which is a trait for of the mother. So the hair color trait is received by the son from the mother. On the other hand, the son also gets the ear pattern like their father, because the father has a big ears. So ear pattern like the father. So the son is a combination of some patterns, some important characteristics from the father, from their dad, and some important characteristics from the mother, from their mom. This is known as heredity, okay? This idea of passing information from father as well as mother into the offspring, into the next generation, is known as the heredity. Now, what I'm going to talk about here, I'm going to talk about the steps, I mean, how exactly the heredity works for human being, how exactly it works. To understand how heredity works in human being, I want to go back, and I want to show you here. I have, you know, one screen opened up with my document. So I'm going to open up another screen here with this screen addition button. So I just click it, and now we are on next page. And in this page, I'm going to tell you exactly how it works. I'm going to pick a color or something to talk about this idea. Okay, so not the hands, obviously. I'm going to take the presenter mode, and I'm also going to take this is obviously not safe, but a title. And here I'll be writing the idea about how heredity works. Okay, I can write this thing with the help of this board application out there. Okay, what is heredity? So we'll be talking about what is heredity. I can drag and drop it in any place, I can delete it, I can copy it, anything, anyway. So how the heredity works. Okay, so the process of heredity, for that I need to take one of my pointers, not this tool. I'm going to take my pointer. So I'm going to talk about this heredity now. So thing is, we have a mother. Let me write it. We have a mother and we have a father. Okay. We have both mother and father. Now, to understand how heredity works, you need to know a little bit about the idea of information. I told you that there are information present both in the cell, information present in the cell of mother and father both, right? So it's present in both this case. I'm going to change the color. I think I can change the color from here. I'll go there and take a different, different color. No, so it's a background color. I'll keep it white, not a problem. But I'm going to just select another color from here, and I also select it a little thin this time. Okay, so that's it. So what I'm going to talk about is that the cell has information, and information means what? Information is encoded. It's embedded in DNA, deoxyribonucleotide. Okay, so DNA is where all the information is stored. And mother has their own DNA, father has their DNA, and their DNA has this information. Now, what is the DNA? DNA contains all the information necessary to build a person. Everything that you see in our body is actually coded in the DNA in terms of nucleotide structures, okay? And this DNA is converted to what is known as RNA, and then finally RNA makes proteins. And these proteins are the thing that we actually can see from outside. Entirely what you see a person, actually you're looking at a protein structure. So totally mostly made up with the protein structure. So the thing is, in our body we have this DNA, and DNA is wrapped, it's compressed inside what is known as a chromosome. Okay, it is present as a condensed form inside chromosome. So how many chromosomes do we have? Normally in our body we have a total 23 pairs of chromosome. Okay, so 22 pairs of chromosome are known as A, or autosome. It is known as autosome. Okay, and one pair for the mother is XX pair, known as sex chromosome or X chromosome. Okay, for father again 22 pairs of autosome. Obviously, let me write pairs here. 22 pairs of autosome and one sex chromosome, that is XY. Okay, this is the sex chromosome for the father. So this is the only difference. Let me take another color from here. Okay, so let me take another, let's say this color. Okay, so the mother has 22 pairs of autosome, which is exactly the same type of DNA present in these 22 autosomes like the father. But the thing different between the mother and father is this sex chromosome. In mother we have 2X, in father we have 1X and 1Y. Okay, this Y is unique to father or male human only, not present in the female human. Okay, so now when we talk about the heredity, as I said, that we have a chance of getting 50% of mother's characteristics, and we have a chance of getting 50% of father's characteristics. Okay, so how we are going to see, let's see now. The thing is, the mother, while they are making eggs, okay, the mother will provide egg obviously, and the father will provide sperm. Okay, so whenever they are producing egg and sperm, the total number of chromosome that they have is reduced in half. Okay, so normal condition, let me change the color again, take red color again. In normal condition, a mother and father both has 22 pairs of autosome. So we call it 2N number of chromosome, okay, for both, 2N number of chromosome. Somatic cell means the normal body cells have this 2N number of chromosome. While during formation of egg and sperm, this 2N number becomes N number of chromosomes, okay. So N number of chromosome is present in the egg, N number of chromosome present in the sperm, okay. So now, so the total number of chromosome is reduced in half. So that means any one of these eggs can travel inside one egg by the mother. Okay, let me zoom in here. You can clearly see here in this right hand corner we have 100%. We can zoom in here to explain this even in more details in here. Okay, little zoom out here. Let me take the hands and let me take this to drag it a little bit, not this one, sorry, Okay, so I'm going to just move a little bit from here, and I'm going to zoom in a little bit here, and I'm going to take another color. Let's take that red color, and let us talk about that. Okay, let's, okay, fine. So what we can see here, that we have this n number of chromosome now in egg. So as I said, this mother can produce two types of egg. Okay, so let's assume that this is X1, this is X2. So in one egg, the mother can give X1, in the other egg, it will give X2. The father, on the other hand, can give, in one sperm, it can give X, in the other sperm, the father can give only Y. Okay, so let me actually change the color of Y, because it's totally unique. Let me put it in the green color like that. Okay, so a mother can give only X to the next generation, but a father can give both X as well as Y in its sperm. Okay. So now what we intend to talk is how exactly they recombine. Okay, now in the next generation, what happened is that this X from the mother and this another X, so 50% of the information, I told you 50% of the information will come from the mother and 50% will come from the father. So from the mother, let's say X1 comes, okay, and from the father another X comes, so it becomes XX, and again XX means what? Female. So it will form a daughter. Got it? Now if the mother gives this X2 and the father gives X, that also produces what? Daughter. Okay, now if the mother gives X1 and the father gives Y, then what it will produce? Let me change the color here. It will produce, you know, X1 from the mother, Y from the father. So it will be a boy. Or the mother can give X2 and the father can give Y. This will also be another boy. So now from this mother and father, what we can see is that these X chromosomes are same. So 2X chromosome means they are literally the same chromosome. Okay. So the mother can give either of the X, doesn't matter, but the father can give one X or Y. If the father gives the X, then the offspring becomes daughter. If the father gives Y, then the offspring becomes boy, okay, or son. So this is the beauty, and you can see that if they have four offsprings, out of four, two are son and two are daughter. Isn't it? So there is always 50-50 chance of a daughter or son. So if somebody asks you that what is the chance that you're going to gain the features from your mother, the chance is 50%. What is the chance that you're going to gain the 50% of features from the father? The chance is again 50%, right? Because there is a 50-50 chance of getting this information, right? So if anything, let's say this is a faulty thing that I draw, so I can take this eraser and can remove and wipe off some information from here. So this is the idea. Now the most important thing, let me erase few things here, okay, with the help of the eraser. It's a good one. Now let me take a box here and draw a box. Here I'll be explaining a very interesting concept to you. Now let me again take a color, which is a red color again. So I'm going to talk about a very good information. Now the thing is, we know that there is a 50-50 chance of being a boy or a girl from the father and mother's origin. But who determines this? Determined by chromosome, right? Chromosome. And what chromosome? Either X chromosome or Y chromosome, isn't it? Now, if Y is present, then it will become son. If both are X, then it will become daughter, right? But the thing is, what actually dictates the son or daughter nature? Inside the chromosome, let me change the color again, let me take a dark black color here. Inside the chromosome, what we have, inside of the chromosome, we have DNA, where all this information are present in four bases, A, G, T, C. We are not going to talk about that in details here, but all these bases, they're arranged in some way. We call it the DNA sequence. And depending upon this DNA sequence, there are different features of the body. Now, what do we mean by different features? To explain different features, I'm going to show you another picture. So let me add another page. I can click this page icon to add another page. This is the fourth page I'm adding. And here I'm going to show you exactly what do we mean by these different features. Okay, so let me go back here, and from internet, from Google Images, let me type the inheritance. So let me talk about like genetic patterns. Okay, and let's say we are going to see different characteristics, or let me write genetic characteristics of human, and let's find out some important characteristics like this. Okay, so let's say this picture. Okay, so I'm going to drag and drop this picture to this board, and you can clearly see that now the picture is on the board quite easily. There is no problem, only drag and drop. That's why I like this my view board application, because it gives you too much flexibility to work on. Okay, so let me take a color. And when I say different characteristics means like this. Okay, cleft chin. You see, some people have this kind of cleft chin, and some has normal chin. Most of the people are without any cleft in the chin, but there are some people with cleft in the chin. This is a genetic trait. Widow speaking is another trait, where you can see a V-shaped structure like that formed by the hair, and this is no widow speak. So it should be peaked like in widow speak like that. It is true for both men as well as women. Okay, dimples. Some people have dimples, some people don't have dimples. This is another trait. Some people have brown hair, some has this kind of blonde hair. This is all genetic characteristics. Some has freckles, some don't have freckles. Some has brown eyes, like most of the people have brown eyes. Like most of the people have normally gray or dark color eyes, but some are very rarely one have the blue eyes. And some people have earlobe which is freely attached, and some has an attached earlobe. So all these are traits, we call them traits. Okay, and there are genes that are present there. Okay, and when we see these genes and traits, there are so many terms. Okay, so genes are nothing but the functional unit of the DNA that is present, that actually denotes what kind of character is going to be. And there are dominant trait a gene, and there is recessive gene. Okay, dominant gene means the gene which is more commonly found. Okay, for example, cleft chin, widow's peak, dimples, for example, in this case, these are the dominant features, and these are the recessive features listed in here, although it's not in reality always, but it's listed in here how it's going to look like. Okay, so this is just an example. So similarly, you will find out, like, if there is a mother and father, the father is tall, the mother is short. Now, there is a 50% chance that their children is going to be either tall or short. We cannot see that for sure. Let's say the mother is fair complexion and the father is of dark complexion. There is again 50% chance for their son or daughter to be fair or dark. Okay, so this is a 50-50 chance, and this is known as a Mendel's law. Okay, what law? It's called the coin flip, or Mendel's law of segregation. There is always a chance of 50-50 to get 50% of the features from the father, 50% of the features from the mother. Okay, so again, I can zoom into this picture to show you the details of this characteristics like that. Okay, or I can zoom out again from this picture. So I can have all this access to zoom in, zoom out features using the My View board. And this is really, really useful in all these cases. And if I want to ask you any question, I can simply click here, and I can put a question there. I can add multiple choice question, true false question, and many things out there for you. So although there is no student added here, but again, I think it has a fairly obvious way to explain the process to you. And the number of pages I'm using here, we can see all the pages and what we use for those pages for. If I want to delete any old pages, we can delete that. Okay, we can delete any of these old pages. Okay, so I can do that. So this is something I think have a basic idea about the heredity DNA, because DNA has this information which is transferred via the RNA into proteins, and ultimately we see the example as a result of the combination of traits coming from father and mother origin. Okay, so if you like this video, you can please like the video, hit the like button, share the video with your friends, subscribe to this channel. And also, if you're a teacher, if you like to teach students with this kind of modern way of teaching, with the help of this colorful pen and pencil, with the help of zoom in, zoom out features, drag and drop internet features, and all these things, you can just log into myviewboard.com, and you can clearly use their software for a better classroom experience. Okay, so that's for today. Thank you.